This is a quick tutorial for Fixel Contrastica 2 for Photoshop, which is the obviously Photoshop version of the very popular After Effects plugin by the same name from the Fixel guys. The Fixel guys basically are algorithm guys. They have these awesome algorithms that do these amazing things for images. And what's really great about them is it does them in a very simple UI. It's very easy to use them with great results. So I'm just going to show you quickly what Contrastica does. Contrastica is a combination of global and local contrast enhancements. And basically, the difference between global and local is quite simple. So, for example, this image here, if I wanted to color correct it, the normal way to do it would be with the curves plug, curves effect. Not normal, but, you know, most advanced color correction starts with curves at some point. The problem with curves, or the advantage, depending on how you want to look at it, is that it affects the entire image. So when I, for example, make the shadows darker by lowering the bottom part of the curve here, you can see that we start getting some really great contrast in her face. Now, normally you do what they call an S-curve, so you also bring up the highs. Now, this is a little bit extreme, so we'll just go a little bit in the middle here. But I'm gonna make it extreme just to show my point more obvious. So her face is looking kind of really nice, obviously a little extreme, but you can see that it actually could be acceptable. There's some other consequences, mainly that the shadows in her hair are just unacceptable, right? It's too crushed. And also the colors start getting very saturated. So this is what's happening now by doing what we could consider a global contrast enhancement. So if you wanted to, say, do one set of curves on her face and then another set of curves on her hair, you would either have to do some extravagant masking or probably some kind of post work. Then you would have to run two sets of levels and then probably a desaturation pass, which would not be ideal. So this is where having Contrastica is really helpful. So we'll go ahead and run it by going under Filter, Contrastica. And the first step you want to do is choose your resolution. So the reason you need to set the resolution is because this determines how Contrastica divides your image for the local contrast. So you want to basically be fairly accurate. So as you can see here, this image is 870 by 870. So from these choices, I would say it's somewhere between high definition and full high definition. So we'll just choose high definition. And then once you select the resolution, you can simply adjust the local contrast, which you can see now is starting to do a really nice job of enhancing her face. And I'll just keep going here so it's more obvious. So as you can see now, it's really pulling out now. I think I went too far because now it's starting to look splotchy. But you can see now that while her face is starting to get very contrasting, her hair is still remaining in a very acceptable place. Also notice that the saturation has stayed pretty constant. So that's pretty good too. So we'll obviously bring this down. And then we can also now go ahead and crank up the global contrast, which is then similar to what we were doing before. So once you basically have the local contrast in a good place, you can just go ahead and again, we'll just go way more than we need here so you can get an idea. But now notice how by grabbing the global contrast to a high number while having set the local contrast first, we're starting to get a much more balanced image, which is really the key here. You want a nice balanced image. So we'll go ahead and lower the global contrast because again, that was too much. And then finally, you have this contrast balance, which basically says, do we want to give the priority in the local contrast to the shadows or do we want to give it into the highlights? So that just basically lets you, if you want a more dark, you know, see where like the shadows here are a little bit darker, or do you want it to actually feel more, lighter? So we'll bring it up and it just brightens it up a bit. I find that generally just want to keep it in the midtones so that, again, the keyword here is balanced. And then finally, you can just bring down the intensity if you wanted to just have it to be a sort of a more subtle thing. So we'll go ahead and leave the intensity to 100. So now that we hit OK, we'll go ahead and just take a look at it before and then after. And as you can see, it just really punches up the image. It really does a really nice job of giving it contrast, but in a very balanced manner. And finally, the last thing I just want to show you is once you've actually set those settings the way you like them, you can then, of course, just go. So that's down here to get the GUI, right, to get all the settings. But once you've done this, so we'll go ahead and go undo. So here's the original image. So now if I just go Fixel Algorithms, Fixel Contrastica 2 here, it'll just apply those sets of values that I had set in the GUI. So you don't have to go into the GUI every time. So on the site, you can really check the before and after and high-res image versions of these images so you can really see what's going on. So that's it. Fixel Contrastica 2, the Photoshop version of the very popular After Effects plugin by the same name. Hope you guys enjoy it.